So what's up guys, it's Technology Help back here. Welcome back to another video, and after a short while we are back with an unboxing. And today we are gonna unbox the Samsung Galaxy M01, which is one of the most cheapest smartphones available in the market right now. And we are gonna check out how is this smartphone according to the price range which you are going to purchase it for, what features does it include, and what are the pros and the cons which you will face if you are going to buy the smartphone. So without wasting much time, let's begin straight with the video. So the exact price at which I bought this device is 7500 rupees, which is quite low as compared to any other smartphone in the market right now. The device packaging is just as similar as any other smartphone you'll find in the market right now. The front side with the branding and the model number. Sides have the branding of the device as well as some of the labels. The price printed on the box is 9999, while I paid 7499, which is quite less as compared to the printed price. On the rear side, some of the highlights are mentioned. For example, the 4000mAh battery, the 13 megapixel plus 2 megapixel dual camera setup, and the 14.5 centimeter full HD display. So without wasting much time, let's quickly move on to popping the box open. So there we are, the box is popped open, and on the covering side we have got a small package with the Samsung branding on it, which includes some of the paperwork housing all the documents and the warranty sheets. Moving on to the base side of the package, we have got our smartphone wrapped in plastic film, which is to be kept aside for now. We have got a basic 5W charger, which is too slow as compared to today's charging speeds, but in the budget segment and for a 4000mAh battery, it is absolutely fine. With the charger, we have got a USB Type A to Type B cable with a micro SIM card ejector pin. And back to our device, time to take off the plastic filming, which is the protective layer. And there we are, the device does come with a sleek and slim design with a basic base setup with single microphone and a Type B charging port. On the right side you get the power button with the micro SIM card tray, and on the left hand side you have your volume rockers, while on the rear you have a dual camera setup with a single flash, a 12 megapixel camera with a 5 megapixel depth sensor, and a basic speaker setup on the rear of the smartphone. This device does come with an earphone port, which is actually good as most of the phones being launched in today's date, they are missing it out. So it's time to boot up the device. As it is being booted up for the first time, it took a little long as compared to the normal boot ups. It took nearly 30 seconds and then it was all set. It was a little weird to see the device asking to update the software before setting it up. Well, that's actually good, the device prefers software updates. Surprisingly, the software update was completed within 2 to 3 minutes, which is actually impressive, and I was ready with the device all set in around 4 minutes. So there we are, everything set up and the device is fully ready to be used. I have no idea why, but I felt as if this was a 30Hz display. On checking out, I found that it is a 60Hz panel, a Super AMOLED one, but still I was feeling that there is a bit of lag on the display screen. Anyways, keeping it apart, the device is running on One UI 3.0 and running on the latest Android, the Android 10, which is actually good. The device has all the software and features updated to everything new. It does not come with lots of unnecessary apps, but it is not clean AF. It does come with a few bloatware apps, as Samsung has already started taking advertisements on the device, which is only done after the user's permission. On the counters of performance, this is a 32GB variant which comes with 3GB RAM. It is not that slow, but we cannot be saying that it is so fast as any brand new modern smartphone. But according to the price range, the performance offered by the device is quite good. The device is actually sleek and handy and very slim and comfortable to be held in the hand. It does have a plastic body, but it does not feel as if you are holding a basic plastic stuff in your hand. It is quite premium and is a bit texturized on its back. The camera setup on the rear includes a dual camera setup where there is a 12 megapixel primary sensor and a 5 megapixel depth sensor. The software UI of the camera is just as same as you find in any other Samsung smartphone, with few basic modes, the pro, the panorama, the depth field, video and all others. It is capable of recording videos at 1080p at 60fps, while the resolution for the pictures can be defined by the user according to their choice. When it comes to charging up the device, it takes nearly 2 hours for it to charge up from 0 to 100%, which is not too fast but not too slow as it is working on a 5 watt charger. So that's all I could explain you about this device. Now moving on to the pros and cons and whether you should buy this device. Well, it does come at an extremely low cost as compared to any other smartphone, offers nearly all features which you need at this price range, and meets up the quality as for the price which you are going to pay for it. For as the cons, you can just say that the camera and the screen quality could have been even better, like it could have been of even higher resolution and a bit better pixel density. But since it is on a budget segment, so you cannot be complaining about such stuff, as the currently present stuff is up to the level. So if you are thinking to buy a first smartphone for yourself, or you have switched from a basic device to a smartphone and you are thinking to get something good at the low price range, then I suggest that this is a good deal. In case you need a smartphone just for using the basic purposes like a basic camera, or you just need it for a simple task like just looking up the schedule or using it as a webcam on your desktops, then still it is a good choice. But in case you are gonna use it for a heavy purpose like playing games the whole day, or some outer stuff where you need to use this device for 4 to 5 days continuously without enough of charging time, then I guess you should push your budget a little higher and go with some better flagships. So that's all for this video, hope you found this interesting. If so, don't forget to hit the like button, and if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe as we keep coming up with such videos every week. Thanks for watching.